Hi everybody. thanks so much, Jay, for inviting me. I'm Stacy Russo. I'm actually a librarian at Santa Ana College down south. And I grew up in the punk rock scene of the 1980s, and it was a huge influence on my life. And I want to just say a few things about that and then tell you about a project that I did. And if anyone has any questions for me or wants to talk with me about maybe an idea for a project you have, and if I can help in any way, I'll be here the rest of the event today. So growing up in the punk rock scene, I mean, I'm now almost 50 years old, 50. So it's been over 25 years since I've been in this space right here, which is really kind of a trip. And but growing up in the scene down south, it was definitely as if, you know, it was a large political movement that we were part of. It really felt like that. And it also introduced me to, like a lot of us, the intersections of all different types of oppression. So including, you know, animal rights and women's rights and class inequalities and war and environmentalism and just all these things that need to be opposed, you know, these injustices. Together. And so that continues to be a big influence on how, you know, I live my life, even as a librarian. That's why I selected thinking about how to make a living. I want to make a living doing something where I feel like I'm helping people every day, so I don't go to sleep and feel like, oh, I made this money not helping in some way. So and even just odd little decisions, you know, in our lives each day, like how to treat people, what to eat or what not to eat, and all those sorts of things all stem from punk rock for me. And then besides all that, just growing up in the scene showed me different ways to be a woman in the world, and I didn't have to follow a traditional path if I didn't want to, because I really didn't desire a lot of what was being shown to me as success or the way to be in the world. So I was able to, like a lot of us, get validation from seeing other people who felt like me and being a part of that community. So this ties into just what I wanted to mention to y'all briefly, is I decided several years ago to do an oral history project and interview other women like me who are now in their 40s, 50s, 60s, maybe at least one of them even older than that, who grew up in the scene down south in the 70s and 80s, and asked them about how they were involved in the scene, why they think they got involved with it, and how it may have ended up influencing the rest of their lives. And that was the project that I did that ultimately became the book titled We Were Going to Change the World. The other thing about the project is I definitely didn't want to only include, as we often see, the stories of the more famous people, even within a scene, right? The people that we'd all probably, you know their names and all that. I didn't want to just include the performers, but to make it true, what I feel more of an activist project and a feminist project and a real oral history, get voices of the scene and women who were involved in a lot of different ways. So those who maybe were fans who went to shows, right, and supported the scene in that way. Those who created zines or did journalism or photography or art, as well as some performers. So there are some women I interviewed who are the more famous ones, but the bulk of the women are not. And that's what I also feel makes the book and the project so special for me. So I did get to meet most of the women in their homes and interview them, and I didn't know any of them except for one before I did the project. And it's probably gonna be one of the best projects of my whole life. And I didn't anticipate that I would become friends with so many of the people I interviewed, and I still talk with them, and all these few years after interviewing them. And so just bringing it all back together to say that I definitely feel that this power, there's a lot of power in stories and storytelling, especially the stories of people who are not as celebrated or are not heard from as much. And if we listen deeply to people's stories, especially those who are not always listened to, it's a form of activism. So I really believe that. So not just for... So it's activism for the person being able to tell their story and feel like someone's deeply listening. If any of you have ever felt like that, where you had, you didn't feel like you were listened to or you were silenced, and then you really feel somebody's listening to you, it's a really powerful thing. But it's also powerful for the person listening, especially if they're gonna take something from that story and maybe even change something about their life or their perspective. So the last project I did is also a book of interviews, and it's A Better World Starts Here, Activists and Their Work. And again, it's about amplifying the voices of people who are not the ones that are, the elites or those that are in the celebrity culture, but people who I think should be elevated a lot more and heard from a lot more, which are activists. So again, besides those aspects of storytelling, I think listening or reading the stories of people who are unlike ourselves, perhaps, for various different reasons, that's also a form of activism because it can break down boundaries and bring us closer together. Because even, someone's story or someone's life that seems so entirely different, once you really listen to that story, there's always going to be places that connect, us as human beings, even if we can't understand everything completely, of course, about someone else's life, there's still those bridges that we can gather through stories. So thank you very much for listening to me today and for having me here.